good. I was hoping you'd still be here.
Yeah, gonna be a little late for the golf course, but you said it was important. So.
It is important, yeah. I got a new recruit for your team.
Oh, is this the kid?
Franklin, this is Professor Holloway.
Nice to meet you.
You too. Holloway's the head of the science department, and he also runs the quiz bowl team I told you about.
Fitzhugh says you're pretty sharp, and the team's got an opening. Have you done quiz bowls before?
Your first name is Fitzhugh?
Just answer his question.
I heard there was prize money. I'll go in.
It's sponsorship money that you'd be splitting with the university, but yes. And listen, don't think this is just some quick cash grab, okay? I know Northbridge is a community school, but our quiz bowl team is nationally competitive with multiple championship wins. We got more trophies than Duke. Fitz, tell me this isn't just some hack opportunist. Is this kid for real?
I vouch for him. I wouldn't waste your time.
Hey, look, I need someone who can be an asset to the team. Is that you?
I think so.
You got to be quick on your feet. You got to have a deep understanding of math, physics, and the geological record. Can you handle that?
I'll give it my best shot.
Your best shot.
Listen, if I show up, I'm going to show up to win, okay? I don't do anything halfway.
Good to hear. Fitz also tells me you have some kind of mnemonic element to your solve process. You said like a musical memory trick?
It's just how I talk my way through a solution.
What, like a rap? Splitnation?
If you want to call it that, sure.
And I've seen it. It's pretty effective.
Okay, whatever you're talking about is not relevant in competition. What matters is having the answer to the question before the time expires. No time for gimmicks, no time for games. Just let me know if you can arrive at a solution accurately and quickly.
I can do it.
You can.
Yeah.
How about I give you a sample question right now?
No, go ahead.
Okay, you're an astronaut on your way back from deep space. You're almost home. A huge CMA, magnetic solar storm, knocked out your ship's autopilot, so you gotta run your rockets manually. You're lined up for your entry corridor, but you're going way too fast, 40 kilometers a second. You gotta cut 80% of that speed or the ship is gonna smash and explode against the atmosphere. So how long do you burn retro rockets that dump 120 kps with an exhaust velocity of 3,000 meters per second?
And what's the full mass of the ship?
1.7 million kilos.
Cool.
So I'm assuming that the crew's not burnt to a crisp from coronal mass ejection. Plus I got an issue with the simplification of things you ignore when you ask the question, but no worries, I got the rest. Slow the ship down and it passed the test. Decelerating is one thing, but if after that we can make it through the corridor, that's impressive. Force on the rocket ain't lost to me. Gotta find a way to chop my velocity. If I'm wrong, I'm a wrecking ball. Got the crew, got the ship coming neck and ball. Use a Newton equation to check it out. Got the second law of my beck and call. All I gotta do is fit the right values to the vectors and now we inspect the model. Right, so showing I'm top speed, gotta slow down, turning 40 kph into 8,000, burning up mass on the retro, 120 is the rate, but I need a breakdown, find the relation, use a rocket equation, when you read it say how, U times natural log at a fraction of mass from finish below the weight now, plug in the V's, we can split up the log, it helps when you ISO the M that you know, from the one that we saw, hit a sexy clip in rotation, can't text you if we don't make it, got the MF term at the log box with the exponential notation. Now that we know about the mass at the end of the burn, we can look at the burn rate function. So you take the burn rate times a variable t and subtract from the mass at the onset. Left side's m sub l. What time do we got? What we want left? Looks like this thing gonna burn 131.82.317 seconds.
So sustained retro rocket engine burn for like 3.66 hours, just about. Slowing down the ship and exhausting about 93% of the total mass. Wow. I'd have to double check that. But
in competition, you get 10 minutes to solve a problem like that. You did that in like two.
That's because the beat was so fast.